condolences to Trish's family. Right when I first got elected as well, she reached out by telephone and offered her assistance if I needed anything and some guidance, since she did have some tenure on me. Along with that, those that have worked with her, were friends with her outside, and I feel for you as well. My second piece is a little lengthy, so I've got a little statement that I'll read, so I apologize for not making eye contact. Sticking on the my written statement here. In recent meetings, I've refrained from comment for a number of reasons. However, there's no better time than now to share my frustration as an elected officer of this county, as well as a tax-paying citizen. Prior to becoming an elected officer of this county, I thought I knew a lot about the happenings of the government. Let me be the first to tell you that, along with a large number of citizens of this county, I was wrong. In my short time as an elected officer representing my district in this county, I have learned that I didn't know so much at all, and have learned a tremendous number of things that are truly troubling, and one of those things I want to share with you right now. The Galesburg Election Commission, which is only one of six municipal election commissions that remain in the state of Illinois, is not run, nor is it funded by the city of Galesburg or its annual budget at all. After living basically my entire life in this community, I will be the first to admit, along with many of my friends and citizens of this county, I assumed that the Galesburg Election Commission was just that, the Galesburg Election Commission that was run by the city of Galesburg and its employees. This, folks, is false, 100%. The Galesburg Election Commission is 100% funded by the Knox County's general fund, which is your tax dollars, and those working for that office are 100% county employees, paid for by your tax dollars. While the ins and outs of this whole thing can take hours to explain, the bottom line that has upset me, and those that I've shared the information with, are equally as upset. The Galesburg Election Commission and employees funded by your tax dollars are utilizing language in the state law to forcibly strong-arm the taxpayers of this county for a raise. We're not talking just a 1, 2, or 3% raise, like our union employees contractually negotiate and receive. They are demanding through multiple avenues that the executive director's position receives a 12% raise, and the assistant director's position receives a 5% raise to their salaries. You heard me, 12 and 5%. The Galesburg Election Commission was formed in 1908 for whatever reasons during that time. I'm pretty sure that nobody in this room can say 100% because I'm pretty sure none of us were there and took part in that formation of the commission. Over the years, municipal election commissions throughout the state of Illinois have ceased operations, with the latest municipal election commission to cease operations after citizens voted to do so at the polls was the city of Aurora just last month. This leaves the cities of Chicago, which we are nowhere near the population, Rockford, Danville, Bloomington, East St. Louis, and us, Galesburg, with municipal election commissions. Currently, the budget for this department is $175,573 of your taxpaying money, with $71,863 of that directly budgeted for salaries of full-time and part-time employees. This number is for purely salaries and does not include the other expenses that each department and each employee, such as FICA, pensions, health benefit, workman's comp, liability, paid leave, such as sickness, holidays, and vacations. With that said, it is my opinion that now is the time that we act as responsible adults and take a look, hard look at what our money is being spent on. When I ran for office, I promised to everybody I spoke to spend taxpaying dollars for the right reasons. And I personally don't think we're doing that at all in regards to this $175,573 of your taxpaying money. By addressing this long overdue issue and seeking to abolish the Galesburg Election Commission, it could potentially save you, the taxpayers, as well as myself, over $100,000 annually based solely on the current line item, which would really be more when you actually factor in the FICA, pension, health benefits, and et cetera, that you, the taxpayers, are on the hook for. The county already has a department that handles elections and certifies the elections within this county with no problem. It hasn't had any problems for years and years. So my question is, why do we need two departments that the taxpayers are paying for to handle this when there's only six left in the whole state, which is dwindling? That's all I have. Thank you.
this was